Hello and welcome to Dell's Gaming. I'm Dell and this is From the Depths Designer, and we are on the beach having a bit of sun, just enjoying a bit of peaceful time in the designer. This is actually the beach of the Twin Guards Island. If we go to the map, you'll notice this is where we are now, which is near the Twin Guards Island area. And this is going to be our testing area for today, or this episode. And we're going to be looking at land vehicles. So first of all, we're going to look at the type of area we're going to have to navigate across. And let me just make sure which is north. Yeah, we don't have to be going this way. So basically, from the beach, we have a nice incline up, which is good in case of floods. And I'm sure if you built a property here, once the war's over, it'll be worth a fair bit. But for the moment, it'll get blown up. So we don't want that. So we've got a little bit of a rise to come up off of the beach. Then we've got this undulating sort of area. Still sort of beachfront. Slightly rolling. And then we're going, it's getting a little greener into a grass, so this is more like a rolling grasslands type of area we'll need to navigate. Some water, a few hills, but nothing major. Now we're getting a little hillier with some defined valleys and some steep hills that might need to be navigated. And it's getting a little bit more valley and precarious. You know, if you get somewhere stuck like here, that's quite a steep incline to get up there. And then where are we going down? This still could be advantageous in these valleys, potentially. So we've got some more valley. It's getting very hilly now. This is heading into the very north part, and we're almost getting, it's not quite mountainous, but it is very, very hilly and would be a bit treacherous to navigate, but not impossible. And then finally, we're coming back into the sea. There's some cliff faces here. That's basically a cliff, for want of a better word, that area there. So this area is not going to be good for vehicles, but the first area, not too bad at all. Potentially good if we look on the map. So this top area here, we can see on the map, you can notice how it's suddenly inclining down. But this area down here certainly is quite adequate. And over here, I think, will be okay as well. So we're going to have a look at this. Anyway, let's get back to the character. So we're going to do some building. And we're going to go through what is needed to create a land vehicle. Now, I have a plan to create a few different land vehicles, but we'll only really go through a build of the basics on this first one, just to show you how it's going to work and what we're going to need to do to get a vehicle to effectively be land. Now, one thing is, it will effectively be amphibious. The idea is that potentially they will start in the water out here potentially, and we might have to come up this steep beach incline, so we'll have to test it against that as well. But for the moment, let's go through the first of basics. So let me bring it back the interface and we'll go into build mode. Now it might give me a block immediately. We'll see if that's, there we go. Now, is that actually usable? Now, that's not a usable block. That's unfortunately a random block. So what we're going to do is go new object vehicle. And we'll bring it up into the air so that we can work on this. So, how is this going to work? Right, well, basically, there is no land item in the game at the moment. The most you have under air is the wheels here, where you've got wheel power and wheel turning, but they actually have no real effect in the game at this second. Their only advantage is they stop any impact damage from hitting the ground. Now, that's what we're going to use, along with rubber blocks. Now, rubber blocks, again, have a similar effect. No collision damage is given or received from these blocks if they touch the ground or are in themselves touched. the wheels are slightly different in that they will give out collision damage, but they won't receive any damage. So we're going to use those couple of blocks in the system. But first of all, we need a sort of like a baseline. Now, this first vehicle I'm going to build, we're going to make a fastish, not too fast, but a fastish scout vehicle, I think, as a starting point. We'll be about that size, I think. We'll see on this one size. So this is when I say fast, it's not going to be overly fast. With these land vehicles, there is still the great possibility if you go too fast around, you're going to go over a rise or etc. and basically land too heavily and quite simply destroy yourself, which is not going to be useful at all. In actual fact, it's far from useful. Almost the opposite of useful. So we don't want that. Now, design-wise, so what would... I'm just thinking of some designs. I'm thinking of the TA Weasel, which, if you know Total Annihilation, old game, that's the sort of thing. Now, I can't do exactly that because we don't have wheels, but we're going to try and implement it as much as we can. Now, let's think. What we're going to need? We're going to need some space on the front here. And then we need some blocks. If we do receive damage, we want to be protected against that damage with some blocks. And also, we want to be able to take a little damage as well from any shots that come in. We do have to think about the armor ability of this vehicle. Now, I'm using all metal here because there's no real advantage of having a lightweight vehicle. Yes, it would be faster, but as I was saying, speed could actually work against us here. I'm more interested in armor, but this is going to be the high speed vehicle rather than being a tank. At least that's my idea. Don't know if that will be the case fully, but we're going to start with that as an idea. So this is going to be our basic shape where we're going to try and fit everything in. So let's start with this area, which is going to be our protection. So what we'll do is we'll start with these wheels. Now, the wheels will end up looking, if I get this roughly correct, air. Now, it doesn't matter which one we use here, wheel or power, there's no difference in cost or any other item. So if we start with one there, now I'm going to put one about, I think every two should be adequate on this. So we start up the top. So that gives us like a slightly track look to it. So as you can see, it's effectively a little bit off the ground. Now I'm going to also use some rubber blocks here, because when we're going across areas which are not level, the center of this vehicle is effectively going to be crunching on the ground. So what I'm also going to do is put some rubber blocks in the center here. And also near the edges, I think. I think I'll put them near the edge as well, just one in from the wheels. So that will just mean as it's more than a big dragging along these rubber blocks than it is the wheels. Although actually I could go like this, put a wheel there, just an inner wheel as well. So yeah, that would just keep it off the ground and make sure it looks reasonable. I'm okay with that. Now we can put a little bit of extra armoring here, might as well, and just in there as well. Now just where's the metal block, we'll put a few more just there just to protect the rear area a little bit, give us a little bit of side armor as such, and I might put a little bit in here as well, just to there. I'm thinking about the aesthetics already. Okay, let's just get this vehicle sort of moving. We might need some ramping on the front here, just to help it get up any slopes. Might have a beneficial effect. So we'll put that there like that. And actual fact, let's do a level one on the first one. We'll make this a two and make this a slope of one. So that way if it hits a slope, the wheels will get it, but if it hits in the center, they will help to push it upward a little bit. We'll work out about the shaping in a second. What I'm going to do now is just sort out the maneuvering of this vehicle, and then we'll worry about armament and filling up the top. I just want to get it moving. Now that we will need an engine, so let's give ourselves a small engine. Won't need anything too large, I don't think here, so maybe about there, some cranks. We'll put the engine at the rear, not expecting to need much at all. Actually, in fact, I might just go for a very simple design. This is just going to be a carburetor, and I'm sure that's not going to be efficient at all. Let's try this. Put some carburetors on this. Supercharger somewhere like there, there, and then some fuel tanks. That's actually a bit big. I'm not gonna need that much. Yeah, that's 700 power. Just I'm only gonna need about 100. So let's cut that down. I went a little over the top on the engine. Right, height. Let's take that rear section off. Possibly don't need quite as many. We'll take that one off, but put the supercharger in say there. How much power has that given me? I've still got 200 power. So let's just take that one off. Maximum power put 200. That means I might be able to put a small shield on there. As such, I'll just sort out this rear, and we'll still end up with more power than I actually need. Which just means I can shield it a little bit and put some other items in here somewhere. We'll put a supercharger down there. Come on. My engine is too efficient. It's adding to the blocks, but okay, that should be good enough for the moment. What power do we end up with? 400. Still massive. Okay, let's not worry about that. Okay, so what do we need to force this forward? Now, speed-wise, this is a fast vehicle, so we're maybe looking at getting around, say, 20 meters a second at maximum. We're going to see what it takes for this to effectively be destroyed. Now what we'll do is we'll give ourselves a little place to sit, which is actually going to increase the speed of this even more, but that's also so I can see. So sorry, we're actually up to 800 power from that small engine because of my buffs, which is more than I need, and I haven't filled it in completely yet, so we'll look at how much we need later. The first thing we're going to do is an AI, because we need an AI to drive this vehicle. We'll put it about, let's see, if we didn't have a turret somewhere on the back here. Yeah, maybe just here would be good. It's going to be sort of central in the vehicle, but there's not a lot we can do about that. Or I could put it at the very front. Let's put it at the very front for the moment. And then we have our left and right slot, card slot. This is our little scout, and I'm going to take off this here, and we'll put in a Let's see what we don't need. This is going to be an aerial. We need an aerial card. And we can put in a patrol card here as now, which is I'm going to put into these vehicles. Now, the aerial algorithm, we're going to say no roll. So we set this angle deviation before roll to 180. That means it will not try to use ailerons and roll function. We'll put that to zero. Cruising altitude, the other bits we're not too worried about at the moment, except maybe these functions here. In that we might not want this vehicle to get too close. So we're going to set this for 250. And say 500, which is the obvious, which is the minimum we can go on there. So it's going to not get too close if at all possible. And we're not going to say go too close forward. So turn at about 15, try and stay within about 15 degrees straight ahead of any target. Right, so how do we make this perform? Because at the moment, move, at the moment it's not going anywhere. Well, basically what we use is, first of all, I'm going to put a little tail plane in. The tail plane, I'm going to put that a little bit lower, we'll just put it there. We only need one, that just makes it aware that it can turn left and right. And what we're going to do is then also put a jet engine. Actually, I'll use an ion thruster on the side. And we'll put a couple each side. And set these to reverse thrusters because they're on the rear of the vehicle. So although there is no, we have no vehicle speed at this moment, let's see if we can, yep, we have no vehicle speed at this moment. If we put it onto, you can see if I put it onto fleet move, it is actually trying to turn the vehicle using these ion thrusters. So it is actually trying to turn the vehicle. So if I go onto the map, I just come off here for a second, go onto map and say, right, you, if I find our new vehicle, where's our new vehicle? And it's not that structure. Let's find our vehicle. Vehicle. We don't want you to move over there. So now hopefully, it's not got enough power at the moment to try and turn the vehicle in that direction without it having some movement. So we'll just try that again. Let's put something a little bit more than these ion thrusters on there then. Let's put a jet engine on there instead. So turn that around, set that to reverse thruster. So there we go. You can see it trying to turn, or it is turning the vehicle. So that's caused our vehicle to aim at that point we were aiming for. Now, okay, we now need some forward thrust. So what we can do is, once again, put a thruster on here. We'll put one there and there. And then make sure they're set to main, which they both are. And let it go for it. Whoops, that's done that. Obviously, you can see it landed on the ground, but now it will try to push itself forward towards that target. It's a little bit haphazard, but basically it's scraping along the ground here, not taking any major damage, but going along around about 20 meters a second. Obviously we've got hardly any blocks. This is just a base unit. We'll need some more power once we get ourselves sorted out a little bit. Now, it's not exactly, oh, I think we most probably are actually reached the point on the map. Yes, we have. So let's just give it a little bit of a longer run. So let's try and see if we set it to over there. No. Right, okay, what we're going to have to do, you can see that the route it's trying to take, it's trying to stay in the low regions. So, which is good. We can use that to as a plan for our ship. So, okay, that's trying to stay in the low regions. Let's say I'm not worried about that. Whoops, we can see it's just turned itself over. Okay, let's just write it for a second, because that's not helping on our testing. But something we can be aware of. Now, okay, cruising altitude. We are going to say we're perfectly fine with it going into the higher regions. So it'll take a slightly straighter course at our target area. So let's see now if we do that. There we go. So it is rolling a little bit, so we could possibly cure that with some stabilizers. So let's try this in two ways. Because it is effectively an air vehicle, we could try putting some ailerons in here, just for when it does go airborne, it effectively will try and right itself and go back straight again. You can see the ailerons are now working to try and keep it a little bit more level. I don't know why it's trying to go that way. I would be expecting it to try and turn the opposite direction. Go on. Nope. Oh, fun and games. Fun and games. We're obviously not succeeding in some way. I think it's because these are too high at this moment. They are above the center point of the vehicle, and they need to be a lot lower. So yes, we're going to have to sort out that thrust. Now, because it's underwater, it won't work. So if we put some ions on the back, so that it will work when it goes amphibious. It'll be a bit slow, but it's a good test to see what it takes to get out of the water. Yep, that's pushing it out of the water slowly. Might need another ion, I think. Let's put another one in there on each side. There we go. That's now pushing it forward quite nicely. Then once it gets out of the water, the jet engines will cut in. There we go. Ailerons are keeping it. It's a little bit erratic. We're getting quite a bit of speed up, actually. More speed than I think is necessary, but this is the high a vessel for going a little bit faster, the Scout. So where's it trying to go to now? Let's come out of here and we'll do set path view and see if we can see where this is heading. And I want to make sure that it's on fleet move. There we go. Well, at the moment, it doesn't seem to be heading to anywhere. Let's just put it onto combat. See if it will go for one of the targets that are actually out there. Well, just at the moment, it does not seem to be heading in the direction I would expect. Oops. So let me just have a check of this and see that the theory's there. We just need to tune this. Let me just have a work on it and I will be back soon. And we're back on the ship. I needed to balance the position of some of the thrusters on the side. It was causing it. I also, by putting in a couple of wings, although it's only one block and not really having an effect, it actually now on the map classes it as an aircraft. Now, it is going erratic and sometimes doing a circle, because it's trying to, but it is trying to follow the path. It's just not very good at following the direction it's supposed to go on, unfortunately. And I might on this just remove the engine that we put in here if I can find it. I put it in just there. Let's get rid of that one. And where's its cohort? There. So we've just got the ion thrusters now at the back providing directional support. Just stops it. It was turning a little too quickly, I think, there. Let's just take that off there. And yeah, that seems to be heading roughly in the direction we want it to now. Just removed a little bit of the stability instruction, so we're going along at a nice 20 meters a second at this moment. In the water it was slow. We might be able to make some changes, but it is now heading towards the correct point now that it thinks it's an aircraft. And also, so I did that by putting a wing in. Just by putting a wing, previously it thought it was a ship. So that was obviously also having a bit of an effect on it. So we can see it's making its way towards that target point. We're just going to see how it deals with some of the higher areas. And the blocks, etc., are all working to ensure it's not receiving any major damage as it is heading towards that, as it's scraping along the ground, which is also good. So that's working. So this will be one of the steep slopes. So let's see if it gets up there. Yeah, it's got enough speed and power just to power itself up. So that's reasonable. Now what we've got to think about is a bit more design. So we've got the basics of how we're going to get this vehicle to navigate and aim for a target. Obviously when we put it in combat mode, it will just go for whatever target it's got. Now we're going to put a little bit of weaponry. This isn't going to be a heavy weapons platform, this particular one. I want to keep this around this 25 meters a second speed. And have it as a scout vehicle with a laser targeting for some laser missiles, and a small cannon, and maybe a couple of small armor-piercing missiles. So let me just take it back to the beach, and then we can start putting a bit more flesh on this sort of thing, some armor on it, and get the basics of defense and attack on the system. I took a little bit of damage there as it went over one of the slightly larger. This could be interesting, straight down into this dip, what it does to it. Yep, see, it didn't take any real major damage. Okay, it's still getting across this high ground, although not as effectively as possibly we would like, but it's still working. So back to the coast, back in a minute. So let's have a look what we're going to go on here. So first of all, we're going to have the front as fairly much armoured. Let's see, I'm not going to go for the straight weasel. I think I'd like a little bit of a nose on this. I think we will possibly push out a little bit more in the centre. Let's see what we can come up with. Maybe, yeah, a bit of a point on this. So if we go in there like this and sort of put the mirror line on first. And let's see if we come up here. This bit have in as well, let me build this up, come up with something, and then we can see what it looks like once I'm finished. So back in a little bit. Okay, we've got a little bit of a platform on the back. Now, what I think would be nice to have is a couple of little weapon systems on the rear here, just to give it some basic defensive ability. And what I'm thinking of here is a little turret, say around here. It's not to be a massive gun, something enough just to at least damage something, but possibly high rate of fire as a priority. Just put it all into the turret. So we're going to start with a quick little one-axis turret. Yep, just a one-axis turret. Don't need to do anything special for this. Now, we're going to put the weapon controller, I think, and I'm suddenly having a problem there underneath. So let's just make sure we find somewhere. Yeah, we've got plenty of space underneath there. So if we put it about here, and then we're going to go straight for the gun. Let's see, we'll do a six-way connector. We'll go back to then an over-the-top design. We'll go with a firing piece, an elevation barrel, and we're not going to worry about too much about accuracy. We'll just give it some motor-driven barrels, about four, and then some recoil suppression barrels. That should give it enough there. Yeah, that's fine. We'll put one more of those on the front. Now, we don't want this too big, so no bigger than we have here. We're going to need some auto loaders, just about four of them. I think that will be enough with some ammo boxes on those. We should be... I'm not going to give it any gauge, so let's see what that's given us. A 0.4 load time, that's not too bad. I think I can increase that if I just put another ammo barrel on the base of there. 0.23, let's fill up the last couple then as well. Let's make this a very rapid fire gun and done with it. 0.13, that's okay. Right, well, we'll give it some armor piercing, because the lightning gun is a lot of alloy, so we've got to get up to at least so we need a 7 or so to get through their armor abilities. We need some, there we go, like that. Let's see if we can get up to 10. 8.2, okay, I'd like a bit more, so we'll put a little bit on there. So we're going for purely armor piercing, no HE, so that's a little bit of a gun on there. How much has that given us? 9.9. Okay, that's not inconsiderable, so that should be fine. Now we need to give this a little bit of AI, and we're going to do this fairly simply. Weapon controller, and now we're going to put the AI for this weapon controller actually on the same point. So just through here, right in the center. No, I obviously missed it. Further back than I expect. There we go. Now we will put a AI connected straight to it, and that is for a good reason. Not on this vehicle, it isn't actually as important, but I have a reason for that. We'll put a failsafe on here as well, because potentially this gun could be trying to fire through the bottom of the ship, of the vehicle. Don't want that. Right, we'll put a bit of armor around this, but nothing too much, I think. A little bit of metal. This also, with the height of this vehicle, should mean that this will be protected, for stop it rolling over, hopefully, as well, which will be a benefit. We need to go forward a little bit. Just put one level of armor, I think, on most of this. Let's see, how can this be shaped? We've got to slope it down a little bit, but not too much. We might have some of it's going to be exposed. So there. Put some metal blocks in there as a bit of armour. And then, let's see, here we'll just have some simple armour, but then we'll put some one. I should be using a mirror line. That doesn't mean I will. Alright, that'll just secure the bottom a little bit. Not necessarily great design. Need some way to go up there so that it will hold it in place. As you can see, blocks don't attach to these. We can't put anything on these, which is a bit annoying. So we have to slide it in. Okay, that's going to do. It's a little bit exposed. And not great design. Far from a great design. Far from a great design. But at least it is a design. Right, we'll put a bit of a metal down here. Back on here, just as a cover this place up. We'll sort out this section a little bit afterwards. At least it will fire. It won't be totally defensive. Now, I'd also like to get some missiles on here. So we might put them out the front here, just here. Create a missile system. Because also, I want to put a laser system on here. So I do a metal slope up. Say, like this. Put some more blocks in there. We're not too worried. Give that plenty of armor. Now, one other thing I'm going to want is a laser defense system. So that's under a laser warner. Let's see where we can fit that in anywhere in here. Now, we could just put it in here. We've got some space, and we don't need much room. So what we're going to do is just simply under AI is create some six-way connectors and just start from there and push backwards. So that will automatically connect it to the mainframe. So we're just going to fill this with the laser warner, which is effectively, I think, will end up just about covering the whole of the ship, but not a laser warning. We'll make it that a little bit less between the warnings, so it will do a couple of smokes each second, and then we'll just put smoke dispensers on here. So it's not a huge amount of smoke, but it should be enough just to stop a little bit of laser effectiveness against it, or in the area it is covering. We will need some ammo. We'll put the ammo in there later. But now the missile system. We've got a bit of room here for a missile system. So what we could have is, let's see, if we had this coming out the side, so a couple of missiles, say four block missiles coming out the side here, and I'm gonna put the mirror line on. There we go. So come out there, then we'll have our six ways here. missile block. The connector, the missile control can go just there. With a weapon controller just behind it. In fact, the weapon controller, can it go below? No, we'll put the weapon controller here, and a little, we'll give its own AI. There we go. We might just put some blocks over the top of this just to protect it. Don't need the mirror line. Let's take the turn the mirror line off. There we go. Right, so there. A weapon controller. There we go. And what else might we need here? Right, we're going to use a laser. So for the missiles, we will go and get a laser emitter. Go onto there. And we're going to set this to team. My team's missiles. And then we'll set these up as laser guided, and we'll see how they go. So basically, it will fire anything that's got a team missile in the area. So laser designator. That way we don't need a one turn. Let's see. Fin. Short range thruster is fine. Couple of fuel tanks. Don't need target prediction. So the rest of this, we'll put another fuel tank on there. That will make it go out to about 1500 meters, which is more than I need, actually. I want this to be fairly short range, to be honest. So let's go for two fins. Short range thruster. Couple of fuel tanks. And then we'll put an EMP in here as well. So we've got an EMP and explosive. Although I could actually go for a fragmentation. Make this a... let's put fragmentation in there. Which is going to be set at a low angle. And then the front will be an EMP. So that will be our... system here. So that just gets those sorted. A fairly quick turning little missile. Just to... get everything in. Now what I'm going to do is just be a little bit more block efficient here. Put four blocks in there and then change that front to be a 2 meter slope instead. Okay, we'll put some normal block. We will put some just normal metal blocks here just to fill in that gap. Don't need any stagger fire. If these fire both at the same time, not too worried on that. And we'll put a single block on the front there. And yes, I haven't got the mirror line on again. We'll put a little bit in there. Let's put the mirror line on first. Thank you. We'll take that one out there. That looks a little nicer. And then we just need to put some blocks on the top here just to make this again a little neater. Nice 4 meter slope down, maybe like that, and then a two in between, something like that. And I'm sort of liking that. 2 meter inverted just there to pick up that part. And we need to allow for this turret to be able to turn. So we'll just fill in this block here with just some metal blocks. There we go. Now, bits we're left to do. Partially, I've got to armor out this back a little bit, and then we've got a test to see how I need to get some ammo into this. Um, And then we just got to see how it turns. We'll put some repaired bots in here as well, potentially, with some a tentacle or two, so that if it gets any of its, if we've got more than one of these out here, they will repair each other, hopefully. So we'll put them down there to help repair each other, and then we'll get a couple of repair bots maybe inside, couple up there, and we'll put some back in this back corner, each side, and we'll get some spares crates in there, so we know that it's got enough just to repair itself a little bit. Now we can armor up some of this area. We need some ammo barrels, a few ammo barrels just at the rear. If it gets hit on the rear, I think we're gonna go big boom time, but such is life. We will put a couple more maybe just there and put a bit of armor around it. So not a lot of metal, not a lot of armor. Put another one just there, actually. And I used totally the wrong word. What I should have said is not a lot of ammo, but enough to kill anything, or do some light damage at least. And that is the end. Now let's just see what the speed of this will be. So we take this off, let it sort of, it's actually trying to fly, which is not a good thing. It's not done to succeed. Okay. So that's not a good thing, but now it's on the ground, zooming away. Speed is reasonable, but not good enough. Okay, let's just try this. Let's take that one off there and double it up in the center there. Now it's gone into the water, which is not a good position for it. Also, I've got to see where is it aiming. Let me just see where on the map we are heading towards. Instead of this, let's just put it into combat mode. There is a target out there, and I'll just go and make sure that there is another one definitely out here that it can go for. Let's just let it, nice simple target. Right, load a vehicle, deep water guard, target. There we go. So that is a target for this to try and aim towards. That's tipping a little bit in the water, but nothing too bad. It's not tipping over totally. Let's see if it heads towards the target. It seems to be heading towards the target. Possibly the fleet mode is, it's not liking the fleet mode, but let's not use the fleet mode. Let's, combat mode is the priority. If it doesn't work in fleet mode, not really a problem. So, okay, it's coming out the water, hopefully. You got enough power? You did get out the water? Yes, it's just getting out the water. Perfect. The heavier tanks, I might use more ion. Okay, and it is starting to fire. And it is firing its missiles. Excellent. I think that the cannon could be reduced on its distance, I think, because that's most probably not really effective. Needs to be 2 degrees accuracy. How are we doing? Yeah, use most, that's when it needs to fire, which is nearer about 400 meters. So we'll adjust this. Sorry for the noise. It's a little loud. Yes, that used all the ammo up. Oh, I should put some rams on the front of this, by the looks of it. If it's going to be getting that close, I think some rams might be an idea. So what if we replace some of this lowest level with rams, if it's going to get that close to the enemy. We might as well be ramming it. Okay, that's good. Okay, well, let's go and change that level. Where's that? It's in here. Let's go and change the controller. So maximum range, we're going to change that down to 400. Instead, right, so it's turning around for another run. And these controllers, their effective range... Oops, there's no laser targeting happening at this second. Cannons now aiming correctly. Laser might need to be a little bit more out to be able to target. Or potentially outside. Let's have a look at what we had here. There we go. So it's got a little bit better chance at actually laser targeting now. And we need to make sure that these are set to... we'll set them only when it, these fire only when it's in front. So launch partner... That's the controller. Going to the wrong place. Controller, we'll say 90 degrees. I think it might have actually destroyed it. And we've got a lot of power on this here, so we could still add some ammo processors. Ammunition processing. Just get that ammo back up again a little quicker. Could put them in this front section. One there. And another one there. And then possibly a shield. So, miscellaneous, a shield projector near the front. Oh, he's coming back for another go. Here we go. Took a little minor bit of damage from the side there. But nothing too good. Actually, did he just take it over? I think actually our own people... I don't know, that seems strange. It seemed to be healing it. But it's on the other side. A bit strange that, but never mind. Okay, so let's just find a position for this shield. Where can we go with the shield? Where can we go with the shields? Just... underneath there for... is good enough, I think. Reflect. Doesn't need to be too long a range. About that width. About that height. No, put that on zero. Angle it. There we go. Maybe a bit more height. At power of 10. 390, I think that was possibly too much. So let's put it down to there. Might have to put that into a different position. It's a little bit too low, I think, now. Yeah. So we'll put that back there. It needs to be about at this level, I think. So I've got to find a block that we can remove adequately. That'd be the laser. So what's the other side of this laser? A block. So if we put metal block in here, let's just see what got removed. It removed the laser. Okay, let's do this again. Right, remove that there. We'll put the first of all put the shield in. It's just in front of that ram, which is fine. Then we'll put those metal blocks in. And then we'll put the laser warner back on. Well, at least we know the smoke works, because that's before I'd done the laser warner. Okay, so it's working, so that shield is just behind here, so let's just set it up. Width 10, reflection, yeah, about that width, a little bit, about 8, height, plenty of height. That one needs to be at a good 45 degrees. There we go. What's that power? 600. Far too much. Bring the distance in. Don't mind a little bit on the front missing. About there. We'll try that. Give that a go. See if that works for it. Gives it a little bit of shielding and a little bit of smoke at least, so it's not without some defenses. Obviously, if the smoke comes on, its own lasers would stop working, but as I said before, this is designed as a multi, as just one of maybe about quite a few of these particular vehicles. Okay, I suppose I should go against something which is actually offensive, so we'll take this off for here. I'm just going to save it. Okay, we'll come up with... It's difficult to know what's going to be up, what it be up against. In a twin guard, because they haven't got anything which is sort of... I would expect to be used. I'm not sure what would be a valid target for it, certainly. We'll just put a Jipachi, just see how it goes against a Jipachi. Right, where did that go? Where is it? It's over there. Let's see if it will actually take out this Jipachi with its missiles and cannons. It's possibly not the greatest of targets for it, but I think it's going to be up against... We're going to create specifically an AA vessel to go against, to be used with all of our ground forces. Okay, the laser is now locked onto the Jipachi. So hopefully that will help to take it out. Did that hit? I'm not sure if that hit or not. I think that did. Okay, so yeah, okay, it's working with the lasers. The laser-guided missiles will work happily to help with this situation. Excellent. That's a good position. It's taken a bit of damage just there, potentially. Was that a bit of damage it took? One thing I didn't put on here was some decoys. And it's having some problems getting it out of the water there, by the looks of it. Not quite enough thrust, so... Also, I need to get my character and make sure that I'm not actually using all of the... There we go, let's get off. And then take back onto this. Now, we're not... Oh, well, yeah, look, we've got loads of power. I was worried about the shield on the front here. I can increase that shield. Got loads of power. Let's give that a little bit more height. Let's put that up to 20. Push that out a little bit more. There we go, but we're not getting up out of the water here, so let's give ourselves a bit more power. No, a bit more. Yeah, it doesn't like that. Let's just try this with a control block. See if I can accelerate it up a little bit. So what we can do is say, if we'll put two in here. Let's see if this will work. If speed, so when vehicle speed is smaller than, say, 5, set the vehicle desired speed to be maximum. No, not quite enough. Okay, we have to put that back again. We only want that. We'll put a bit of a delay on that. And this one is when the vehicle speed goes above 10 again, then desired speed goes back to 0, simply. That's fine. But it's not getting out the water. Now, let's just check. Yeah, putting that there does it. So what we'll do is we'll do like that, and maybe as long as it's a little bit out of the water, that will be enough just to force it out by having that slightly higher higher jet. We'll put another one in. I'm just go for a little bit more speed. There we go. So this is our weasel. This is the saved it as the weasel. So this is the basis. It's sort of based upon the old Total Annihilation weasel. Obviously, somewhat of a license with the looks on that. But it's a good start. This is our scout ship. Next, I think I will have a go at maybe our main battle tank, which is going to be a much bigger vehicle, much slower. And I'm also want to look at some AI changes. So as this one just goes straight for the target, our heavy tank will actually stop once it's within a certain range and just fire until there's nothing within range. So it will stop to give maximum accuracy to its main gun, because it's all going to be about the gun with the main battle tank. So as always, leave comments below if I've got something seriously wrong, but this is working. I think if I bring in a few of these, they're only 600 blocks. It's a bit bigger than I expected, but 600 blocks, that's not too bad. I think if I bring in about 4 or 5 of these, few heavy tanks, a missile version, an AA gun, and some artillery, and I've got an idea for a missile platform as well, but I'm going to spawn these in. I think when that comes in, that should be quite good. So, until next time, keep playing. Post your ideas up on the spawn or in the forums. But most of all, have fun.